Hello and welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. For this video, we're going to take our Casio fx-9750GII calculator and get into some basic graphing. Specifically, what I want to cover is how you can start entering equations into the calculator, how you can adjust your window size so you get the best picture, and of course, how you view that graph and start finding some key values or key points on that graph. That's what we call the trace and evaluate features of the calculator. So let's go ahead and jump right into it by grabbing some equations and of course, grabbing our calculators. All right, let's go ahead and turn this thing on. Now for graphing features in this particular Casio calculator, you want to go into your Casio menu. Most of the time when you're doing just regular old calculations, you'll be in the run slash matrix mode, but you want to go into the graphing mode. If you happen to already be in that math mode and you really want to get into the graphing mode, then you want to press your menu button first. That'll bring you to your main menu. Then you can arrow over to the graphing mode and press execute so that you're in the graphing mode specifically. All right, so again, make sure you press your menu button, get into graph, and now you're ready to start entering in these equations. Okay, so the first one we're going to enter in is this x cubed minus 2x. And you'll notice that it already has the y's listed in there as y1, y2, so we'll only enter in the right side of this equation. So let's use our variable button, so x caret 3 minus 2 X, and I'll press enter, and now the equation is stored inside the calculator. Now, if I want to adjust the window and get a really good picture of this, the next place I want to go is under the viewing window, or V window. To get to that, I'll have to press shift and then F3 and make some adjustments. Let's go ahead and do that. So shift, F3, and let's adjust our window. Now, by default, usually you'll find that your window's X min and X max will be between negative 10 and 10, and the same thing will apply to your Y min and your Y max. It'll be between negative 10 and 10. For this particular equation that I'm graphing, I think it looks best when the X minimum is around negative 6 and the X maximum is a positive 6. Let's type in negative 6, enter, positive 6, enter, and that'll adjust my X values. Now we'll arrow down over to the Y minimum. So y minimum, negative 6, enter, and y max, 6, enter. Now there's a lot of other things in here. You'll notice that there's a scale feature. It says 1, and that really just means every tick mark you see on the graph represents 1 unit. So everything looks good for our window. Let's go ahead and hit exit, and we're back to our equation where we have it stored in. Now that we've adjusted our window, our equation is actually in the calculator. Let's go ahead and take a look at what this thing looks like. To get to that, you want to go to your draw button. You'll see it under the menu, and we'll have to press F6 in order to see this. So let's press F6, and it'll go ahead and it'll draw out the graph, and it looks really good. So it's got a few dips, a few valleys, but sure enough, this is x cubed minus 2x. Now, if you want to make some adjustments or you made a mistake, you can go back to the equation. Just press your exit button, and you're back at your function menu. And then you can either delete it, rewrite it, you know, make some adjustments how you see fit. Now, we're also going to graph another equation on here, and I'm going to put that under y2. So this one is the square root of parentheses x minus 20, close parentheses. Now I have two different graphs. All right, let's press enter. Now they're both stored in the calculator. Like before, I can immediately go to my draw by pressing F6, and it'll attempt to draw both of these. Now you'll notice you only see one of them. That's because the other one is way off the screen. In fact, it doesn't even start until x equals 20. This is another good application of why you want to know how to adjust your window. That way you can see both of them and get a really good picture. So let's go ahead and adjust our window by going Shift V Window. And let's make some adjustments by setting the x maximum all the way up to 30. That should give us enough x value that we'll actually be able to see both of these. All right, so I'm going to press exit. Oops. Let's go ahead and press 30 to make those adjustments. Enter, so they're saved. Exit. Okay, now I'm back to my equations. Let's press F6 so we can draw them both. And there they are. So here's the first one, dips and valleys. Second one just starts to increase very slowly. Now, if you only want to graph one at a time, you can definitely do that. Again, we make some adjustments back at our equation menu. So let's go ahead and press exit. Let's go ahead and shut one of these off You can do that a couple of ways. One way is to just delete the second one out entirely. That's under F2, so it says DEL for delete. And then you get the options of whether you want to delete it or not. I'm not going to delete this one. I'm going to leave it there. Or you can actually just tell the calculator, go ahead and keep it, but don't draw it. And that's what the F1 is for. It says SEL for select. So I'm going to press SEL. And the change that it's really made is the equal sign is no longer highlighted. Only equations where the equal sign is highlighted will be drawn if we actually graph this thing out. All right, so only the first one is highlighted, so that's the only one we'll see. Let's go ahead and press F6, draw out the graph, and sure enough, you only see the first one. All right, so now that we know a little bit more about graphing, let's adjust our window one more time. Let's reset the X maximum back to 6, enter, and get into some of those trace or evaluation features. Okay, so our window is from negative 6 to 6, Y max and min, negative 6 to 6. Exit. Let's go back into draw. Sure enough, we just have the first equation. All right, let's go ahead and start tracing it and evaluating it. To trace it, you'll press your shift button and then F1. You'll see it says trace right above that button. Shift, F1. And now when you move your arrow keys, this little plus sign will start moving along the graph. Below, it'll tell you where that little plus sign is located. So currently I have it located at around 1.7, x equals 1.7, y equals 1.6. That's where it's located. It'll also tell you in the upper left what equation it's on. So right now it's on the x cubed minus 2x equation. If you want to evaluate this at a specific value, a good way to do that is actually just type in the x value and it will jump to that one. So for example, maybe I really want to know what it's doing at negative 1. So I'll type in negative 1. And you'll notice that it automatically brings up this enter x value screen. It knows that we're trying to type in an x value. So x equals negative 1. I'll press execute. And it'll immediately jump to x equals negative 1 and give me the corresponding y coordinate. So I know where it is on the graph. I know it's x and y coordinate. Looks pretty good. Let's do this again and type in x equals positive 2 and see where that is. So I don't really have to do anything other than just press 2. It knows I'm putting in an x value. Looks great. Press execute, and sure enough, now it's jumped way up to here, and it's at the point 2, 4. Nice. All right, so hopefully that gives you some of the basics of how you enter in an equation. You can always get back to that menu screen if you want to get back to some regular calculations. You'll just go to your menu screen, but that's how you get to the graphing portion of this thing. All right, if you'd like to see some more videos, please visit MySecretMathTutor.com.